Hi, and welcome to Chair Tai Chi. People are joining as I speak. We have about 3 more minutes to get started. So grab your water and your great smile. Thanks for joining me. And if you were on the other class or any other classes, make sure you mute your mic as you come in, because as you come in, we record the class. So whatever you say is recorded. Kind of a little awkward there. So thank you for muting your mics, and I appreciate your time. We have 2 minutes to get started. My name is Coach Dina McDee. Chair Tai Chi is a beautiful way to stretch your body, to strengthen your muscles, and believe it or not, being seated, you're working on balance. So it is such a blessing that you're here. We're going to get started in 2 minutes. Thank you. I'm learning a lot about Zoom. So as we do these Zoom calls, they're going to get better and better and better. It's that learning curve, right? So thank you for coming on the journey with me, my Zoom journey. It has been this old dog learning new tricks, and I learned a lot, and I share my knowledge, because sometimes the best way to learn something is just jump in, and you don't know what you don't know. Like, I don't know until something happens. So here we are, and it's time to start class. So let's get started. Go ahead and sit tall in your chair. I'm gonna move my other toys from my other class, but I'm keeping my water there. Sit tall, I need to fix my screen just a second. Thanks for bearing with me. Here we go, perfect. Arms come out to the side, sit tall. Tip it over and look up. Inhale, exhale back to center and change sides. So nice you joined me. Thank you. Just continue that slow movement from side to side. Big breath, exhale. One more each side. Exhale. And back to center. Draw your arms in, elbows are high, fingers point together. Push down. As you rise, let your elbows rise and invert that motion, bring it down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Now sit tall in your chair. Engage those ab muscles. Lift those shoulders. I always joke about wearing a tiara or a crown, but that's the feeling you want, is that upper strength through your neck and shoulders, sitting tall and strong. Last one, and release. One hand comes up with your foot, small range of motion. Don't go too high, we're just warming up. Small, hand comes up, your thumb points up. This is called the rooster, so think of that rooster's comb with your fingers sticking straight out and up. My daughter has roosters. Nope, has chickens. They lay blue eggs. As crazy as that sounds, they're in Missouri. They can have chickens. We can't have chickens here in Florida. Two more each side. Last one. And release. One arm comes out, circle it around, lean in and around. Come across shoulder height and reach it out. So if your range of motion is a little smaller, that's fine. But if you feel like you want to extend a little farther out, always work your own pace. Exhale. Beautiful job. One more this side. And bring that hand straight down. Other hand rises up, extend out, and circle around. Like your arm was on a table. So keeping that elbow high, round, contract it in. Big breaths, exhale. One more. And release that down. Leaning to the side, make a circle. Now, your lean doesn't have to be big. It could be small, but it can be a little bit larger. Inhale, exhale. Never hold your breath. Keep breathing. Now reverse that circle. Whatever direction you were going, go the other way. Take your time. No rush. Look down toward the ground, keeping your chin toward your shoulder. And release back to center. Let your ear fall to one side. Change sides. Last one. Back to center. Drop that other arm down. Lean into that and make that circle. Small at first. Big breath. Point those fingers down. An added element is looking down toward the ground. Reverse that circle. Big breath. Slow, large circles. Like you're stirring water. And release, bring it back to center. Both palms come up. You're gonna lift one foot up and two hands. And bring it down. Lift and reach with your hands tapping your shoulders. Back to center. Slow and steady. So you pause at the top. As you lift, you pause and hold. Release it down. One more each side. And release. One arm reaches out. as you bring it down, flex that hand. So your fingers point down and flex as you come back. Change sides. Up. Flex down. Sit tall. Sorry, sometimes I forget and you start to just relax that posture. Lift that chest up. Pull your shoulders down and back. Strong posture. Last one, and release. Both hands come up, one is on top, one is below. Make that air a little bit larger than a grapefruit, and just rotate those hands. Hold it there, now lift that chest. Rotate and hold. Feeling those shoulder blades become a lot more supple. Who thought moving slowly could be so powerful? It is. Adding another element, you're going to turn and look over your shoulder. So whatever hand is on top, look that direction. And slowly turn and look the other way. And hold. Rotate and look. Turn. One more each side. And coming back to center, rest your hands on your thighs. Lift one foot up, flex it forward. As you get to the top, point and flex and draw it back to the center. Change. Flex forward. Point. And flex and retract it back. Continue with that movement. Big breath, exhale, hold those shoulders in place, flexing forward. So show me the bottom of your shoe. Perfect. Flex up. Point. Maybe your range of motion does not have a full extension. That's okay. If it's down low, you're still moving through that hip joint, through that knee joint. And one leg may be more flexible than the other. Mine is that way. I'm more flexible on my left, although I'm right-handed. Who knew? Maybe I was supposed to be left-handed. I don't know. Last one. And release. One hand again is on top, one is underneath. You're going to lift one elbow high and extend at an angle. Hold it there. And draw it back to center. Turn and reach. Look up. That's an added element as you change your gaze. Bring it back. And out. And look up. big breath, exhale, and bring it back. Let's do three more at your own pace. You want to go a little slower than me, just don't go much faster. Breathe. Sometimes we have a tendency to hold our breath when we're holding motion. Sometimes you stay here and you hold not only the motion, but your breath. Don't do that. Bring it back to center. Now just changing hands, whatever hand was on top, change that position. Lift over to the side and open and make that long motion, look up. Back to center, keep your elbows high. You look so wonderful, your posture is amazing. Reach and look up. Back to center. Breath, we have two more. Last one. Back to center. Bring both hands down. Scoot to the edge of your chair so you have ability to go back. Hands are on top of your thighs. Add a core circle. Now, as you go back, see if you can touch the back of your chair with your back. If your range of motion is smaller, that's just personal. You have to know your ability. Working out doesn't mean what your neighbor's doing, it's what you're doing. That's so difficult when you're in a fitness center. You're seeing other people do things and you're like, ah, I should do that. No, sometimes the answer is not today. But today you might be doing a huge core circle. Last one. Take your time and back to center. Start slowly and go the other direction. As you're able, extend that circle out, bigger each time. I feel my lower back smile at me if it could. My hips feel happier with this simple movement. Don't rush it. It's not a race. We're going at our own pace. Last circle. And release. Grab some water and we'll jump right back in. Anytime you want to get a drink of water, that's your call. You have to know your body. If we're working out, you're like, well, I'm thirsty. You go get a drink. Okay, separating your feet, chair width apart, which is bigger than shoulder width. So the legs of your chair, your hands point down. You're going to take to the inside of your knee that angle and just rotate it around to the other inside of your knee. So that's your perspective of your circle. Yes. So that gives you a very nice angle of rotation. Doing lots of circles today. And up. Circle it around. If you hear bird noises, that's my music. I love it when I have the friends coming on my music. And release. Now, simply reverse that circle. So you go about shoulder height, and down to your knees. Hands are together. Now, if your arms are bent, that's fine. That's your range of motion. Ideally, you want to keep your arms straight. Last one. And release, bringing it back to center. Placing both palms on the top. Lift that foot and flex it. And just place it back down. So your legs are open wide. Lift, flex that foot, and release it down. Lift and flex. So it's a wide leg lift. Open. And release. One more each side, and we'll add an arm element. So lift that arm and rotate up, reach. Then it comes back under. Lift and rotate and reach. Bring it back center. Very nice. Lift, rotate, reach. If that's too crazy, you can just do the arms. If that's an option, maybe you just do the arms a couple times. And then come back with both arm and leg. The lift does not have to be super high. You can even maybe just lift your heel. So think about these options as you go through the class. Some days I'll forget to give you options, and you can remember. Last one. And back to center. Draw your feet back to shoulder width apart. Both arms reach down. Now lift that chest, pull those shoulders down and back. Open and close your arms. Big breath, keeping it small. Now open it a little bit farther each time. At your own pace. A little bit higher than shoulder height. If you feel comfortable, bring it all the way above your shoulders. Straight up above your shoulders. A full range of motion. Now, if you're able, tap those wrists together in the top and bring it all the way down. That is a big stretch. I feel it, yes. Tap and bring it right back down. One more. And exhale down. Extending your legs, start with your toe up and point it out and bring it back with your toe and place your foot on the ground. So it's a toe, extend, and toe, and release. So you've got that motion. Open, back, release. The concept is to draw it up, reach it out, and draw it back in and place it down. We'll add an arm element in just a moment, getting our legs in game. Now we're going to add that arm. It's going to reach forward. Your other arm draws back. Together, release. Toe, hand, reach back. Yes, a lot of things to remember on this movement. Up, reach forward, reach back. So you have a spinal twist motion. Continue. Now, Try to do it without a pause. So you just come back and reach. Gorgeous. That is a hard move. Beautiful job. I feel like I'm running in slow motion, because we are. Out. One more each side. And remember, if you want to stop and take a break, grab some water. Those are your choices. Last one this side. And back to center. One hand reaches completely out. Grab and pull it back. Place your hand on your thigh. Same thing, other side. Open. Grab. Pull it back. Place your hand down. Reach and grab. And place it down. Sit tall. Big breath, exhale. Adding another element to that, you're going to reach into that grab. Pull it back. Place it down. Reach into that grab. Here we are working on our balance. Say, for instance, you need to grab something off the counter. You're reaching and grabbing. Right there. Everyday movements through what we do today. You don't realize how often you use certain moves until you become off balance. So these moves keep that balance structure. Everyday life. One more each side. And release. Dropping one palm to the down to the ground. Your palm is up. Scoop it around. Keeping that arm bent. I'm not keeping a tilt. I'm keeping my arms or my chest strong. So you're using that tricep over your head. See, my upper body's not moving. I'm just using that arm strength. Lift it up. It's a bicep strengthener. And now you're in your tricep. Yes, as you come up and around. Continue with that movement. Circle, little half moon. Big breath, exhale. Adding an extra element, lean into it and come around and lean. Back to center, drop it down. Scoop around, lean into it. Last one. Now my music has running water. It's very quiet. Here it comes. And release. Changing arms, your palm turns up and down. Once again, the first set, we're sitting tall. You're not leaning, you're only using that arm strength. Lift it up. And try to touch your ear on the other side. If you don't make it, that's fine. You want to get that element of stretching that tricep, the back of your arm. Now maybe your shoulder's a little tight. This is the shoulder that is a little tight. I can feel it working right here. Last one straight. Now if you choose, you can lean into that scoop and back to center. It's a scooping motion. Your abs are working the whole time. I feel my core. Last one. And release. Lift one foot and just circle that ankle. We just have a couple more minutes. Reverse that circle. And change feet. Sit tall. Circle that ankle. Reverse that circle. And going back to the first leg, but this time use the opposite hand. Circle. Coordination. This hand is not my smart hand. Reverse that circle. And release, changing sides. Lift up, opposite hand. Circle. Just use your wrist. Reverse that circle. And release. Big breath up. Exhale down. Again. Big breath. Push that air down. Continue. Lift up. Maybe even lift that chin up. Come back to neutral. Center. Last one. Up. And exhale down. Just rest in your hands on your thighs. Sit tall. Maybe lean back in your chair just a little bit. You want to close your eyes. Let all the tension go. You've worked super hard. Just allow your muscles to recharge through rest. Big breath through your nose. Loud, hot breath. Inhale. Exhale. Open that jaw. Inhale. Exhale. Just back to normal breath. Open your eyes if you're not already open. Sit tall. Big breath out. And exhale into prayer. Remember, you are amazing. Clapping for you. You're fantastic. Thank you for joining me. My name is Coach Dina McDee. This is Chair Tai Chi. I lost my headband. My hair tie. We're going to have lots of fun, so stay with us. And the learning curve's getting fantastic. Each class gets better and better. So thanks for joining me. My name is Coach Dina McDee. I will see you tomorrow because I will be here for Chair Tai Chi. Bye.